If you had an opportunity to go live on the moon, would you do it for fun, or only if it was your last chance of survival? Even before the first humans set foot on the lunar surface during NASA's Apollo program in 1969, people around the world were dreaming about a permanent moon base to colonize Earth's nearest cosmic neighbor. Many believe that it is the inevitable next step when our current home becomes uninhabitable, no thanks to us. From the decreased gravitational pull to the lack of an atmosphere, it makes us wonder, how different would our lives on the moon really be? Is it actually feasible to sustain a civilization? Curious? Well, let's take a closer look. Pairs of astronauts have lived on the lunar surface only up to 3 days at a time. In the tiny lunar module of the Apollo program, space exploration has long focused on the moon, with Earth's satellite being the setting for a number of significant missions. A 1959 Soviet spacecraft photographed the moon's far side for the first time, and in 1969, NASA landed people on the lunar surface. Numerous missions followed, including NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter that beamed home the highest resolution topographical lunar map to date, covering 98.2% of the moon's surface. Altogether, the collected data seemed to suggest that no place on the moon would be a pleasant place for humans to live, at least compared to Earth. Due to the moon's rotation, lunar days stretch for about 14 Earth days, with average temperatures of 123 degrees Celsius or 253 degrees Fahrenheit, while lunar nights also last 14 Earth days and maintain a frigid cold temperature of -233 degrees Celsius or -387 degrees Fahrenheit. The only viable place humans could live for extended periods of time would be at the poles, where temperatures are around 0 degrees Celsius. Perhaps the rest of the moon's surface could be a new vacation spot for people to explore the craters or the historic sites of the Apollo landings. A beautiful sight for any lunar conquerors would be the solar eclipse, as the Earth would create a red ring of light in the lunar sky. No need to check the weather though, because apart from the drastic changes in temperature, every day would be sunny with no rain, wind, or any precipitation for that matter, which results from having basically no atmosphere. However, one danger would be moonquakes, as the moon is seismically active and can produce hour-long quakes that could easily cause structural damage to the kinds of buildings we have on Earth. In terms of basic survival needs, the average 800,000 calories that an adult human needs per year could cost a total of $5.9 billion in transport annually, although there is the possibility of using lunar greenhouses developed by the University of Arizona, which can produce 5 kilograms of lettuce, sweet potatoes, tomatoes, and strawberries. Water would cost another $43 billion in transport, hence extracting any local water, say lunar polar ice, would be essential, and $1.5 billion for the shipping and assembling equipment for us to be able to breathe inside shelters and spacesuits whilst on the moon. Some scientists think that humans could even survive comfortably on the moon. In some ways, the moon is actually more conducive to life than the International Space Station, a zero-gravity environment where our bodies experience muscle loss, brittle bones, and vision difficulties. Even though it hasn't been formally tested, some experts hypothesize that the gravitational force on the moon, although less than the Earth's, could help stave off some of those adverse effects. Of course, the bodies of the inhabitants would still need to adjust. The cardiovascular system would need to work harder to pump blood down to the lower half of the body, and the muscle mass would shed. Living in a bubble with a lack of natural diversity would lead to weaker immune systems. Due to the lack of an atmosphere, inhabitants would also be exposed to radiation, and that is an issue that would need to be resolved immediately. It might sound like something from a fantasy movie, but experts in private industries and governments around the world are trying to understand how feasible it would be to establish a lunar base. European Space Agency found that a base using materials already available on the moon could be a practical way to establish an outpost. Under the ESA's hypothetical plan, a robotic mission to the moon could do most of the work before astronauts ever needed to set foot on the lunar surface. The robot would use a mixture of lunar dirt and dust called regolith to cover an inflatable dome with layers of the robust material. Once on the moon, experts might be able to actually use mined lunar material to manufacture the gases needed to sustain life. So what do you think? Would you want to live on the moon someday? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please let us know by giving it a thumbs up. And if you want more content like this every week, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. See you next time!